Hello and welcome to my channel. In this video, we want to install PostgreSQL on Linux. After the installation, we will create also a first data bank and a super user with the login rights and with password so that you can, after this video, use this data bank and this user for each and every application that you want on your system. So let's go and let's do it. As you know, PostgreSQL is an advanced object-relational database management system that supports an extended subsets of SQL standards, including transactions, subqueries, foreign keys, and so on. For installing PostgreSQL, you have to run a command, but before that, I will suggest you to update all the Linux repositories with the use of sudo apt update, and after that you just press enter. After updating, we install PostgreSQL. Sudo for installing PostgreSQL, you have to run this command: apt install PostgreSQL, and after that we just press enter. And here it will be asked if you want that these packages will be installed on our machine or not. We say yes, we want it, and after that we press enter, and we wait until it will be installed. It takes just some seconds. Here you see that after the installation, we have to run another command so that we can start the database server. First, we have to wait until it will be finished. And as you know here, the version 12 of PostgreSQL will be installed on our machine. So now it's installed, but for starting that, we have to run this command also. I just make a copy of that and I paste it here. So we have to run it with sudo. Good. Now we can check if Postgres is running, is active on our machine or not. With the use of sudo systemctl status Postgres. So here you see that we have two services, PostgreSQL service and this service also. What is the difference between these two services here? The first, this Postgres.service, it starts and it stops all of the Postgres services at the same time that are running on your machine without mentioning a specific partition. This one is a template file so that multiple version of Postgres can be run on your system at the same time, and we use it to start or to stop a particular version of Postgres. So Postgres version 12 is installed of on our machine, so we check it. We use this one, and as you see that Postgres is now running on our machine, and we can log into Postgres and create a data bank and create a user for that. For connecting to Postgres, we have to use another command. So as you know, when we install Postgres, it will be automatically an account also with the name of Postgres installed on our machine, and with the use of this account we can connect to Postgres and we can do our job. So for connecting to Postgres, we use this command sudo -u for the user Postgres. That is the Postgres, that is the user, the account that will be automatically with the installation of Postgres also created and installed. And PSQL is the CLI of Postgres, the interactive terminal of Postgres for working with Postgres, and after that the data bank. So I press enter. Now you see that we have opened the CLI of Postgres, and right now we can do the job with Postgres itself. The first thing that I want to show is, for example, we want to check the list of the databases that we have already. So for that, backslash and L, after that press enter. You see that by default it will be Postgres and template 0 and template 1 installed on Postgres. After the installation it will be automatically done. And the users, if we want to check which users we have with the use of backslash and do, and if we press enter, you see that right now we have only one user, and it is this user here, Postgres, that we have used, and it is a super user and has these roles here. Create role in Postgres. If you want to create a user will be called role in Postgres. It means that with the use of this user or this role, you can create another role, and it's a super user, you can create DBs and so on. Now we want to first we create another data bank. So for that, create the Postgres commands. You can type them in big or in small letters. It is not case sensitive. Postgres is not case sensitive, but I would suggest you to do it always in big letters. So create database, and after that you select a name for your database, my DB, for example, and don't forget to type the semicolon at the end of the command. After that we press enter. You see that create database. Now if we check the databases that we have, this time you see that we have another database, and it is the database that we have created. Now we create another super user with as I said, with the login rights and with password. For that we type this command, create this one, this time rule. As I said, a user will be called rule in PostgreSQL, and after that we select a name for that. This name I would say test user. It is up to you which kind of name you select for your account. And with login, and after that super user and password. And here we select a password for our user in the single quotes. So I say test 123. You have to set a better password, of course. And after that, again, semicolon. Now I press enter. You see that create rule. And this time, if we run this command also, you see that we have two users. And this user is also as the super user. If you want to grant another rules to your user, you can do it with the use of alter, and after that user, and the name of the user. In this case, this is test user. And after that, create rule, for example, for the first one. And we press enter, alter rule. Now, if we check the rights of our user again, you see that this time the test user has also this rules, can create rule. And so you can do it for another rules here. For example, alter rule, alter user, test user, and this time it will be create DB. And you press enter, and this time you see that the user gets this role also for replication and for bypass. You can do it also again with the use of this command, alter user, the name of the user, and the rule that you want replication. And if you press the tab, it will be automatically here, and you just press enter. And for the last one, again press enter. So now if we check it one more time, you see that we have a test user, is a super user, and has all of these roles here. Now if you want to do something more with in Postgres, you just type backslash, and after that a question mark, and after that you press enter. So you get all of the commands that you need for that. And you see that if I scroll down, there are too many commands that you can use in Postgres. And after that, if you press Q, it will be you come again to the CL after Postgres. And if you type exit, you come again to the terminal of your Linux. So that's it. I hope that you like it and it was useful.